Greetings. This is your brother, Armin Falcon, broadcasting live from the planetsphere known as Earth and Tiamat, third rock from what you call the sun. However, there are many suns, and we shall address that in future videos, but I must have you know at this time that Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune are all three suns. That's why they have the acronyms S-U-N. More on that later, but for right now, I actually want to get on a subject which is most pertinent to the development of the people in our civilization at the current time, and that is law. People don't have a full understanding of law, they will not be able to properly apply the law when required for their unalienable freedoms. First, let's start with the definition of law, and I'm coming from Black's Law Dictionary, and this is the 5th edition. I do have the abridged version. It would be better if you get the unabridged version, and you will have more in-depth history of the word and not merely a definition and pronunciation and the language from which it was taken, which is predominantly Latin. And you must know Latin. You must know Latin. Once again, you must know Latin language. Latin is not a dead language. The Mediter is not a dead language. These languages are still being used spoken by people on this earth, and as long as there are billions of people on the earth, these languages will never leave. As a matter of fact, Latin is the official language of the Vatican, and Latin is the official language of the Latin court, and every attorney, whether they be so-called on your behalf or not on your behalf, every attorney has an obligation to uphold the Roman Catholic Pope. Now, let's start off with the definition of law. Law, that which is laid down, ordained, or established, a rule or method according to which phenomena or actions coexist or follow each other. Law, in its generic sense, is a body of rules or action or conduct prescribed by a controlling authority and having binding legal force. That's why you must be very careful about how you define words. Typically, when you're in court, if you do have a book that they want you to put your hand on, typically there's not even a book there. It may be a Black's Law Dictionary. In some older courts, there may be a Bible, but typically now it's going to be a dictionary or Black's Law Dictionary. It's going to be a dictionary of use that defines the word that are used in court, because those words are the most pertinent, and their meanings, when expressed in writing, can have severe effects if you do not know what those words mean. You can start off with the word person if you want to examine what a person is. A person is not what you think a person is. A person is actually an entity that can be controlled by several entities at one time. Okay? So that's how you get the Holy Trinity, and that's how you get the judge, plaintiff, and the defendant. You're going to learn what these titles actually mean, okay? And you will also learn how to retain your jurisdiction in the courtroom, and that's what's vital. This is coming from a brother who has got the judge about his jail, and he took a recess, and was here in the most horrible state, where the most evilest atrocities get done by judges. This is Florida, okay? This is the banker. This is the dirty. And I'm going to show you why they call it the dirty. It's because of this dirty, evil system that they got in place. Okay? In Old English jurisprudence, law is used to signify an oath or the privilege of being sworn, as in the phrases to wage one's law, to lose one's law. The term is also used in opposition to fact. Thus, questions of law are decided by the court, while it is the province of the jury to resolve questions of fact. You have to understand what's going on here. Let's back up. What were you told laws were when you were in physics? Probably 9th or 10th grade if you came through this Babylonian educational system, which slows you down. There's only three mathematical subjects. It's algebra, it's geometry, and calculus. I'm going to teach all three of them. Okay? All people need to know these three. There's no reason on earth why after 5th grade you haven't mastered all three of these math subjects. Okay? In 1st grade, they want to teach you addition. 2nd grade, subtraction. 3rd grade, multiplication. In 4th grade, division. It is chaos. Okay? They slow you down from reaching your maximum capacity of learning. You got a 12-year-old boy. He's in Morehouse right now. Look it up. And he's 12. He was homeschooled, but that's irrelevant. Who says that their system of learning is better for a certain individual that might be of a different nation and has a different heritage? You can't say that the way people on the Eastern Hemisphere or on the Southern Hemisphere, if you're in the Northwestern Hemisphere, you can't speak on how those people should be taught unless you've been a native of that area or unless you have direct knowledge of what's required to sustain life after becoming of age and of the age of accepting responsibility. The word may mean or embrace body of principles, standards, and rules promulgated by government, statute, or enactment of legislative body, administrative agency, rules and regulations, judicial decisions, judgments, or decrees. Keep that in mind, because you can make your decree as well, and your decree has higher standing as long as you never, ever tell anyone that you understand them. Okay? This is vital. Tell them you do not understand them, but you will continue to overstand what is going on. Those words are vital, because if you don't say that you understand and stand under their authority, there are certain things they can never do. In essence, they take your God power in court. They're holding black mass. It's a satanic ritual held by high priests, and the Pope has the keys to hell and death. So someone has to do his bidding for him, his work for him. Okay? In the Bible it says whether it be good or whether it would be evil, we will obey the voice of thy Lord God. So the people that follow out the commandments from someone claiming to be God are going to follow them, no matter whether they personally think they're good or personally think they're evil. Prime example, Moses killed an Egyptian that killed someone else. And we're going to get off of all this Egyptian crap and stop accepting the names of what someone millennia later gave to a section of land known as the Nile Valley Civilization, or Tamaré, or one of the affiliate lands. Ta means land. Okay? Let's continue. With reference to its origin, law is derived either from judicial precedents, from legislation, or from custom. As to the different kinds of law, or law regarded in its different aspects, see absolute law. Okay, so they're going to now refer you in the Black's Law Dictionary. You can go in and take a look for yourself as to the different types of law that are being referred to. So there's many, 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 there's a multitude of laws. Okay? So what you are witnessing, as you may very well know if you are conscious at all right now in Babylon, is that the law of the land, the true law, is uniform commercial code. And that's the reason that our people are being tricked in court every single day. They do not understand what is going on in commerce. Point blank, period. That's it. They do not understand. They do not understand. They do not overstand. It's a good thing they don't understand. But they better be able to have a reasoning of it, and they better be able to evaluate what they are seeing and what they are hearing, more importantly. The words that they are hearing will make a difference in their lives. Earlier I touched on the subject of law, and there's many types of laws, as I've stated, but I asked you, what was law in physics? Now, when we were in school, we were given several laws. Everyone knows Newton's law and all these other somewhat acceptable laws. I'm not going to name any more Europeans to give them any more credit for these original sciences that Imhotep and other ancient people that are now about the civilization, well before Imhotep, had mastered and were performing. Maybe not have categorized it with that name that you gave it, gravity, magnetism, but nevertheless, these subjects were studied and mastered. What we know and what we knew law to be is Mayat, and only Mayat. That is still, to this day, the only law that is present in the entire solar system and universe. Mayat, which is balance. The woman balances the man. It's a balance system. There are scales. Mayat had scales. Thought had scales. Okay? So that was already and always the duality principle present in the Nile Valley civilization in the land of Tamari. The laws of physics cannot be broken. So once again, let me restate that. The laws of physics cannot be broken. Having that these laws, and you learn these laws well before you learn any American laws and all the crap, excuse my language. The laws of physics cannot and can never be broken. A law, which is, I would say, is the third level up. The first level being that of a postulate or just a guess. Then that the next level would be that of a theory, scientifically. And a theory is backed by other theories and postulates. Okay, the highest degree would be that of a law. A law is backed by other laws, other theories, and other postulates. And you don't have to prove a law. You can actually disprove the contra negative of the law and thereby prove the positive of the law. It can be done. laws can be proven in many realms from which you don't think laws can be proven.